What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. We have a very special video in store for you today. You might want to stick around. I know the video is a little bit long, but the title says all. I'm sneaking courtside to every single Golden State Warriors game of the 2018-2019 season. And I'll show you guys how I'm doing that in the middle of the vlog, but right now I'm about to head to the Warriors game right now. They're playing the Jazz tonight. And unfortunately, of all the days for me to start documenting how I'm doing this, there's no courtside seats available tonight, but I'll be sitting like in the first like three, four rows or something like that. So I'll be sitting there tonight, and I don't want to make this intro too long. I just want to get into the video, but just for a quick synopsis of what I'm doing. The Warriors have this thing called the In the Building Pass, and you pay $100, and in return, they give you a ticket to every single game, but it's not for an actual seat. It's just so you're supposed to go watch the game inside the club. You're not actually supposed to go inside the bowl area, which is like where all the seats are. I get the ticket that they give me for the In the Building Pass, and I Photoshop it to sit courtside. And like, I've done this for over like 20 games and counting. Like, I'm just trying to do it the whole season. I've not got questioned once. Technically, it's not free, it's $100. But if you add up all the games I'm going to, I'll probably end up going to like 30 plus games the whole season, sitting courtside, or at least in the first couple rows. And if you just do the math, that's like $3 a game, so that's pretty much free. I'll get more footage once I get to the arena.
Free Warriors game. Free tickets every game, baby. Me in here.
And it's another day, and we're going to another Warriors game. They're playing the Sacramento Kings, and I haven't shown this yet, so I'm just going to kind of show the process, what I do to Photoshop the tickets and all that. So I'm using a program called Adobe After Effects. You could use Photoshop if you know how to use Photoshop. I don't really know how to use Photoshop. I know how to use After Effects, so that's what I'm doing. I take a, I just make a JPEG picture of my sequence. So that's a photo. So I just use that photo, download it to my phone, and then use that as my ticket. So this is the process that I'm using for the Photoshop tickets. So this is the program I use. It's Adobe After Effects, and this is the original ticket that I get, and I take a screenshot of it, and then so you can see Warriors. This is when I went to the Jazz game, Warriors versus Jazz, and then they give me the ticket that I bought, C200, that stands for Club 200, standing room 2, and then it's just some random number that they give you. So this ticket is supposed to only get you in to the Club 200, which is not even a seat inside the arena. Or it's in the arena, but it's not where you can see the game. It's just a club within the arena. But all of the tickets look the same though. So even the courtside tickets, they all look exactly the same, except for they just have different letters. So what I do, entry gate where it says East, Photoshop that out. I just put some of the white over East from the other part of the ticket. And then you put BMW VIP below south entrance, because that is the entrance that you would come in if you had a courtside ticket or a courtside club ticket. So I put that, and then up here, boom, you just use a lot of the gray to go over the original part of the ticket. Wow. That, and then at the very top, you just replace Club 200 with Courtside Club, which is the section of seats that you're going to be sitting in. So, boom, and then at this point you have a blank canvas, so you can put whatever seat that you want. I found out what font they use. It's called Rational Display Demo, and so I got the font that they actually use for the tickets. And then you just go on Ticketmaster, and you see what seats are available. So I went and did that, and so right here, section 24, row A5, seat 8, and then boom, you got yourself a courtside ticket. Fifth row from the court, BMW VIP entrance. And so, as you can see, it still says Warriors versus Jazz. And you're just gonna change that once they send you the ticket. They send you a ticket about 3 hours before the game. And
it has the actual like for the next game I'm going to, it's gonna say Warriors versus the Sacramento Kings. And so you just Photoshop this part right here. Since you have this done and this down here done, it'll have a part where it says Warriors versus Sacramento Kings. You just replace this part with the Sacramento Kings part, and then you got yourself a brand new ticket.
Clip. I said I was going to the BMW club. I did go, but I just didn't get any video or anything like that, which I know, like, oh, of course he went there. But I took a picture with the two of the NBA championships trophies that the Warriors have, which was in the BMW club. I'll put the photo right here. But tonight, I'll be going inside the BMW club, and I'll make sure to get video of it, because I can get in there pretty much any game with the Photoshop ticket. And I'm gonna try to sit courtside again. Hopefully there's a open courtside seat, because this is a pretty sought after game against the Rockets. So it could be that there's no courtside seats available, but if there is, I'll be there. It's kind of crazy that this is like an actual hack that I found that's actually working for every single game. So I'm in the BMW club now. The ticket worked, of course, to get the inside access to the BMW club. And the BMW club is just a club that's exclusive to only people that sit courtside club. So yeah, they have a bunch of food here for people to eat. It's like a buffet, a bunch of good food, alcohol drinks. I think you have to pay for the drinks. Food is free. Food looks pretty good too. I'm about to give you a plate. And then I just chill here until game time, I guess. Back to my car, and that completes the adventure for today. I would say that was a job well done, a mission successful. Got courtside seats again for free. The next game is against the Celtics. I'll be there hopefully. Hopefully I can still get the same courtside seat or even a better courtside seat, and we can continue the streak of getting inside these Warriors games for free and staying courtside. I wear this jersey every single time because this is my lucky jersey, and I've gotten in no problems every single time as long as I've worn this jersey. But yeah, now to the Celtics game.
Come back to this subject, so we'll see what happens.
Does it for the Warriors versus the Celtics. Got courtside again, as you saw. But, yeah, the Warriors got smacked. I'm not going to lie. That was a pretty embarrassing effort on their part. Yeah, I'm not going to talk too much. Just go to the next game. I think the next game is against the Nuggets in a couple days. So I'll be at that game. Hopefully sitting courtside. Getting footage. And I haven't said it in this video yet, but make sure to subscribe and like this video and share this video with your friends. I feel like this hasn't been done before, or at least it hasn't been done and put on YouTube before. I feel like it's a pretty crazy hack that I found, and hopefully Ticketmaster doesn't change their whole system and these arenas, and like you could do it in your hometown arena. It's not really that hard learning some Photoshop, but yeah, I'm not trying to like take up too much of this time. To the next game, the Nuggets. That's it for the Warriors versus the Nuggets. They got a good win. Only if they could play like that every single game, that would be nice. And we could sweep our way through the playoffs, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, don't want to take up too much time. On to the next game, which is the Warriors versus the Pacers. It's in a couple days. Warriors with the good win against the Nuggets. Now let's get that dub against the Pacers. And that game is coming now. That does it for the Warriors versus the Pacers. Warriors with another strong win. Something hella cool that happened this game was I was sitting like a couple seats away from Ryan Coogler. If you don't know who that is, he's the director of the movie Black Panther. And another person who I saw that came right next to Ryan Coogler to go talk to him was Reverend Jesse Jackson. Yeah, I actually went and shook his hand and everything just to introduce myself. I would say that it was a pretty legendary day that not only I met those guys, that I snuck courtside to a Warriors game once again.
All right, so it's another day, and we are here at Oracle Arena, right outside the Oakland Coliseum. I just realized it's gonna be Dirk Nowitzki's last game playing at Oracle, so that's gonna be pretty dope to see and be a part of. And I'm pretty confident that I'm gonna be able to get courtside once again, so I'm gonna make my way inside right now, and we'll see what we get. Once again.
Right.
I had to get out of there early. It's my first sports game I've ever left early at, but I just couldn't watch that no more. That shit was ridiculous. This is like the corridor where people walk. Who knew when you Photoshop your ticket, you can get to go out where the players come out.
And I'm on my way to the next game. It's been a minute since I've been to a Warriors game. I was out of town for about a week and a half and I missed like two or three games. I had to go to this game though because this is the final home game ever at Oracle Arena for a regular season game, because next year they're moving to San Francisco. Bittersweet, but you know, I had to go to this game because I'm a diehard Warrior fan from back in Monte Ellis and Baron Davis, Steven Jackson, all the OGs. But yeah, so I'm on my way to the final home game of the regular season. And I don't know if I'm gonna do this to the playoffs because they don't have the $100 thing where you get the club tickets. They don't have that for the playoffs, so I would have to buy a playoff ticket. And I might do that, but I don't know. Playoff tickets, even the cheapest ticket at the playoffs, still pretty expensive. It's about $150 for the cheapest playoff tickets for the first round, and it just gets higher and higher as the tiers go. I'm kind of disappointed that I didn't get a front row courtside seat the entire time, but just every single game, they're all sold out, so I didn't get a chance, including this game. But there's a courtside seat in the BB section, which is the row directly behind the courtside, so it's still considered courtside. That's where I'll be sitting tonight. So yeah, I'll record more once I get to the stadium. All right, we made it. Oracle Arena, last home game in regular season of all time.
Coming in as a broadcaster, broadcasting the loudest name I've ever heard, which was Game 6, if we believe. Never heard that. Thank you to everybody. Love you. We'll see you in the playoffs.
game at Oracle Arena in the regular season. It's against the Clippers. We got the dub. Bittersweet, though. The last game at Oracle had 47 seasons there. But now on to hopefully bigger and better things in San Francisco. They're still the Golden State Warriors. It'll always be Oakland's team because, you know, it's Bay Area to the death. That's the only Bay Area basketball team, so we're repping it hard no matter where they are in the Bay Area. You know, there's a lot of talk about KD leaving. As long as Steph stays, he's the real Bay Area boy at heart. We've accepted him as our own. Him and Klay and Draymond, that's the core three. As long as they stay, everybody should be happy. Hopefully KD stays too, though.
To this point, with Kevin Durant deciding to join the Brooklyn Nets.
But now they got other business to attend to, like winning that NBA championship.
There's a new NBA champion, and it's a team from Toronto, Canada.
And I actually think that I'm going to be going to the first round and probably the second round, hopefully the third round too. I don't know if I'll be able to make it to the finals. Finals tickets are like just insanely expensive, but I should be able to pull the first three rounds, at least one game each in the first three rounds. And if I do, that'll be in a separate video, sneaking into the NBA playoffs. But with all that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and share this video and comment down below. Make sure to share this video with all your friends so we can get those subscribers up, and then we can just keep on going up, and you know, I'll get a million subscribers, and then I'll should have enough money to go sit courtside legitly, and then maybe I can take a subscriber with me one time to go sit courtside at a Warriors game, a Laker game, or something like that. Yes, please make sure to share this video. And Golden State Warriors organization, if you're watching this, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Joe Lacob. I know you guys are kind of hurting. You only made a couple $1 billion this year, so I hope you guys will be fine that I didn't pay my my 10 grand per game to go to sit courtside and stuff. Make sure to subscribe to the channel for all the future uploads, which hopefully will include me sneaking into the playoffs. And I will end it with this. My name is Trevor Laub, and I hacked the entire Warriors organization. Joe Lacob, might as well just give the team to me. Thank you for watching. Like I said, subscribe, like this video, share it, do the whole thing. You know what to do. So, peace.